Hello everyone, welcome back to the Syntax UK YouTube channel. My name is Matt and today I'm going to be taking you through a quick setup guide for the ADI-2 FS. Developed as a stripped down version of the ADI-2 Pro FSR and ADI-2 DAC FS, the ADI-2 FS features the same high quality conversion as well as the ADI-2 chipset. So this is a really affordable, no-frills way of getting the ADI-2 circuit design into your setup. Another product that we mentioned on this channel before is the DigiFace USB, which is a 66 channel USB audio interface and it features only ADAT connections. Now, the only form of monitoring that you get with this is a stereo headphone out. So pairing the DigiFace USB via ADAT with something like the ADI-2 FS would give you a really high quality, mastering grade even, monitoring setup. You can combine the ADI-2 FS with any of RME's interfaces, whether it's a Babyface Pro or any of the larger interfaces like a UFX2, a UFX Plus, or an interface like the Fireface UCX, which I'm using here. This brings me on to another benefit that the ADI-2 FS would bring to your setup, because it features RME's SteadyClock FS, which is their latest digital clocking technology. If you're not familiar with what digital clocking is, it's a really integral part of audio conversion. Our friends over at RME Germany have created a really informative video about just that. So that's a little bit of a rundown of the ADI-2 FS itself. So I'm going to get into getting this connected up to my UCX and getting some sound out of it. So I have my ADI-2 FS and UCX here, so I'm just going to turn these around and we're going to get started. So what we're going to be doing is we're going to be connecting the ADI-2 FS with the UCX using the ADAT input. So we've got the Fireface UCX in going to the output on the ADI-2 FS and vice versa. And then over here we have the analog output section, which is where I'm going to plug my speakers into. And then I'm going to connect the ADAT inputs and outputs together, obviously making sure that the ADAT in of the UCX goes to the ADAT out of the ADI-2 FS and vice versa. Next, we need to sort out the clocking for both devices. For the ADI-2 FS, this is done on the front panel, and for the UCX, it's done through the Fireface settings application. You can see currently that the lights on the clock and on the state in the ADAT are both flashing. This means that there isn't a sync. We're going to take advantage of SteadyClock FS. So I'll be using the ADI-2 FS as the device that our clock signal is taken from. So we have the clock section, digital input and digital output. You can simply press the clock button until we have the desired sample rate. So that starts with 32, 44.1, 48, and then it goes into double speed. So in double speed, we can go up to 96, and then QS or quad speed, which goes all the way up to 192 kilohertz. There is a final option as well. If you wanted to use the clock from a separate source, then you click one more time, and that goes to the clocking from the digital input. So I'm gonna choose 48 kilohertz and leave it there. Next to this, as I just said, is the digital in button, which we need to select as optical, so that the ADI-2 knows where to take the input from. And there's finally the digital output section, which we're going to put to ADAT to make sure that it's matching the digital input. Now this is all done, I'm ready to go over to my computer and make the adjustments needed here. Here on Fireface USB settings, we can change various things like what the optical connection is taking, whether that's SPDIF or ADAT, as well as the clock mode and sample rate. So the first thing we're going to do is change the sample rate, and we're going to match the sample rate of the ADI-2 FS by turning it to 48. And then we're going to change where the clock is coming from, change this to optical in. And you can see the lights on the front panels have now stopped flashing, which shows that there's a sync. And you can see this in Fireface USB settings as well. So now we're going to move over to Total Mix, and what we're going to do is try and get some sound out of the ADI-2 FS. So I'm using AS1 and 2, which is the first digital channels on the UCX. And we're going to change the main output to AS1 and 2. So now when I click this main output here, everything is connected to the AS1 and 2 submix. So if I turn up this software playback channel,
which has got some audio coming through a media player. That's coming through the main output. Another thing that you can do with the ADI-2 FS is click the analog input button until it shows digital. And what happens is this disables the analog input side of the ADI-2 FS, meaning that the meters now show the digital input signal, which is perfect for being able to see your monitoring levels at a glance.
And that's that. We have the ADI-2 FS hooked up to the five-phase UCX, and that's now providing SteadyClock FS for some improved digital clocking, as well as providing a high-grade quality monitoring solution for my UCX. If you've enjoyed this video, please do make sure that you like, leave us a comment if there's anything that you'd like to see on future videos, and as always, please do subscribe to our channel. Thanks very much, guys, and I'll see you again next time.